This is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's use Google Forms to create simple online surveys. So you've probably seen surveys on the internet. You've probably taken many of them. Sometimes you see them as a post in Facebook. Sometimes you get them in email from a company you do business with, maybe from some friends or some organization you're a part of. It's really easy to set up a survey. You can use a variety of different websites to do it. But the easiest and cheapest way to do it is to use Google to do it. It's fairly simple and I've done it several times for MacMost. So let me show you how it's set up. So I'm starting off here in Gmail just to demonstrate that all you need is a Google account. And it's the same account you would use for Gmail or YouTube or a variety of other Google services. So it doesn't really matter that I'm starting here. I'm just showing you I have a Gmail account here. And I'm going to go over to drive.google.com. And when you go to drive.google.com, this is where you can store things. It's kind of like their version of iCloud. And you've got the ability to create a new document here. And when you do, you get new, and then it shows you the main ones, docs, sheets, and slides. But we're actually going to go to more and create a Google form. So let's say you're the parent in charge of deciding where and what to do at the end of the sports season for your child's sports team. So we're going to create a survey for that. So you can let the rest of the team decide. You can put a description here or you can just get going right to the first question. It's going to put a multiple choice question there by default, but you can change the type of question here. We'll look at those in a second. And you could put there's already going to be an option one there. You can click to edit it. And then you can click add option to add another one and edit that one. And let's add another one. And then when you're done, you can basically go down here and you can select whether or not this is a required, like they have to answer this. They won't let them go past the survey submitted without answering it, which is certainly what we want to do here. The three dots are extra buttons for extra things here, like a further description for the question if you wanted to get a little more detailed, for instance. And now that we're done that, we can go and use these buttons here on the right to add things. So you can add all sorts of things here. You can get really complex here adding videos and images and things like that. We're just going to add another question. So at the end of this question, for this question, this is going to be a short answer. And so maybe this is actually a better one for a multiple choice, and we can do yes and no, and maybe so here this one might be a short answer. So just let people type whatever it is that they want to type. And then of course we want to know who these people are. And we'll change this to short answer and just so we have the email address handy, we'll change that to short answer as well. So you can go and play with all the different types of questions that you can ask. You got interesting things like a linear scale, so they can choose a number on a line, a grid of choices they can choose. You can have a date. So for instance, we could add one here that's like what date would you like to have the party and things like that. And when we're done, we can basically, the thing's ready to go, and now we can preview it. Just use the preview button here, and it'll go to another page, and then you can see what the survey will look like, and you can even try it and fill it out. That kind of thing, and hit submit. Close that, go back here. And we also have settings, so only allow a person to submit one response, that kind of thing. And then we can hit send. Everything's automatically saved. We can go up here to edit the title for this. But we can go right in here and hit send, and we can send right here by email, and we can type in email addresses here, put a subject and a message, and we can even include the form in the email or just have a link. It's probably the normal way to do it, so they would go to fill out the survey. So let's pretend we've done that, and if we go back to the Google Drive page here, we can see inside forms here we've got now our recent form there. So at any point we can go back into this and edit it. Now if you don't want to use the regular sending function here, you can actually switch over to the link here and it will just give you this link. You can even shorten it there to make it a very simple link. And you can copy and paste that in anything. So if you want to send this message or post it to Facebook, for instance, or maybe there's a regular email you send out to the team anyway and you want to include that link in there, so you don't want to use this function, you want to use a link, you can do that. And this will allow people to go to the form and not have to get an email directly from it here. So let's say that you've sent it out, and let's take a look at what happens when people get it. So here I'm going to go to this shortened link, and there's the survey. Let's say pizza place contributes soda. And we'll hit submit. Great. So now we can go back over here to the forms and I can look at responses, and I can see, if I refresh the page here, there it goes, each response. So I see this little chart here and it gives me details. So 100% of the response so far said pizza place, and then there's the list of things here. But in this case I'm going to see individual responses, so I'll click on that and I'll be able to go and see the individual response here, and then I can flip through them to see each one. So I can go and see what everybody responded, just like they were sheets of paper. I could also, if I wanted to, click create a spreadsheet and create it. And this is useful because now I can click on that again and review responses. Now I can see it all in a Google Docs spreadsheet. And this Google Docs spreadsheet will automatically update as more people fill it out. So I go back over here and say it's another person and they want to go to the restaurant and they can't come early. It's always somebody wants to just bring paper plates. And they submit. Great. So now I go back to the sheet here. And look, I didn't even have to refresh the page. It automatically put it in there. So you can kind of keep this one open and watch the responses roll in and easily see, okay, Gary wants to bring soda. This person wants to bring paper plates. Here are their email addresses. And very easily run a survey like this. It could be something for your business. It could be something personal like this. Something just for fun among your friends. Very easy to do, and it's free using Google Docs.